preconceive anyway how you're going to react. Don't go into a certain room, a gas chamber, a death chamber, a barrack, and expect that you're going to cry or you're going to laugh with a friend, because how you perceive yourself to be is definitely not how the outcome's going to be. You're your own person. And I think I felt that in the forest, where I saw a lot of my friends crying, and me myself, I was just in shock. And I was just looking around, and then once I actually saw a picture of, I'm assuming, one of the children that were killed, and it looked like me. And I just didn't know how to react. I was very overwhelmed.
Told the story when we're no longer here. Don't let anyone tell you that it didn't happen, because you were here and you listened to a survivor.
I wanted to come where to living because my grandfather was a survivor. So it's something really close to my family, and I know that it's something that has affected who he is as a person. So I think that being able to somewhat comprehend how and where he came from is really my main motivation to come on the march.
I knew what I was walking on was what my grandfather had walked on. And I knew that I was walking in the same path as him. I don't know, it's really moving. I can't word it in any other way. I mean, I saw his bunk. He said in the movies that his bunk was 13, and I saw it, and I can't describe it.
Well, we just toured Auschwitz, and it was just... it was crazy, and the whole time that I've been to all these concentration camps, it's so difficult for me to even grasp, like, to be sad. It's just so difficult for me to understand how this ever could have happened, and how so many people lost their lives just because they were different, and for no other reason than they were hated. And to be here with so many people that, like, I just see it's pandemonium right now, and everybody's here for the exact same reason, to remember these people and to commemorate their lives, and it's just such a special thing that I can be a part of.
One of the children that they were going to murder, and I escaped from the murderers and I survived, and my whole generation was wiped out. So today when I see people 15, 17 years old, this is my generation, that was lost, and it makes me feel very good, because what we're doing is we're telling the world they did not prevail.
I'm terrified, but at the same time, so, so happy. I've never seen anything like this. There are people who are blind here, people from Czechoslovakia, people from Greece, people from everywhere. And I didn't even know that this many people existed that cared this much.
The Holocaust was 6 million, but after hearing Nate speak and the other survivors speak, it was 6 million testimonies. And unfortunately, we can't hear 6 million testimonies because they're not alive.
And that's why coming here, it's so difficult. I have to relive the pain of loss every year. But I'm doing that. I'm doing it because I owe it to you. I owe it to the world. Today, when I stand in front of all of you, and I look at you, and when I, 69 years ago, when I stood here and there was no hope, I see nothing but hope.